going to show you how to show and hide rows with the use of a checkbox without the use of a macro. So here we have the most basic list I could think of. And so this would be the possible items that you would buy on your grocery list. And what from this list and with the checkbox, we're going to create a shopping list. So what I did is I selected the top item from my on my second sheet, on my shopping sheet, I selected the top item from the items and pressed enter, and it's linked so that each of the items are reflected on both pages. And so now what I've done is I've put a checkbox next to it. So what I've created is checkboxes next to the items, and on the shopping list there is a true next to the items that I need. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you how I did this. So I'm going to go in the next to the bread item here. I'm going to click on the cell beside it. I'm going to go to my developer tab, go to the toolbox here, click on it, and I'm going to click the checkbox from the form controls. Now I'm going to press my Alt key down, click in my cell, and you get a checkbox. Now, I don't need any text here, so I'm going to just delete this. And so now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click away, and then I'm going to right-click on this, and I'm going to select Format Controls. Okay, so let's click in here, and let's click on the little red arrow to minimize our dialog box. Let's go to our shopping list. Let's go next to the bread and click there, and we'll click our little red arrow again, and we'll say OK. So if we click this, and we go to the shopping list, then we'll have a true next to bread. To get just the items that we need, we're going to go to the, we have an automatic filter from the data here. We click on our top item, we click on the automatic filter, and we're going to drop down, and we are going to just select, we're going to just select the true items. And so there you have the list that you've checked, the milk, butter, bread, true. Now, but we need the heading for bakery here. So let's show you how I did that. So I'm going to click and show all the items. And now what I've done, I have selected all the cells next to the bakery, and I have named it in the name box. I've named it bake. So if I've got any items selected in here, I would like the heading to show. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a formula in here, and I'm going to do count if. So equals count if, and we'll do opening brackets, and we'll select our range that we've named, which is bake. And you can see it on the list here, so we're going to double click that. And we're going to say if any of these equals true, so we'll type in true here. Now, if there's any more than zero trues in here, I want you to show the heading. So we'll go greater than zero and press enter. So now, bakery, because bread has been selected, the bakery heading has been displayed. So now we can, once again, go to our drop-down list for our filter, select true, and there we go. There we have all our items, including our headings, in our list. Please subscribe.